world thinks I have the biggest crush on you, Kalani.
You don't.
I love you with my whole heart.
You're my sister.
You are one of the hottest women in the world. I see your pictures and I'm like, thank you. Yes, bitch, better work. You could not be further from my type.
I know.
I am a firm believer in like your person will be your person. Like, I love
so
you,
it's
but
not,
you're not
my person.
I'm happy now. I'm gay and I'm alive and it's great.
I'm gay and I'm alive and it's great.
Yep.
I love that's going to be a TikTok sound.
What are you literally?
I'm gay and I'm alive and it's great. It's my third night with this partner. It's really fun. I'm happy. I'm having the time of my life. Cut to the next day. My dad comes up to me and he's like, so you guys had fun last night?
No.
And he was like, last night you called me.
No. He thinks you're in trouble and he picks up the call and he's like, she's drowning. Oh my God.
Well, she kind of is.
Why does it sound like JoJo's only breathing out of one nostril?
So now I have a rule that no matter what, phones are away because I butt dialed my dad. I want to let it burn. On this night, actually, she gave me the best advice ever. We were backstage, and she nonchalantly was like, can I tell you something? And I was like, yeah, anything. Like, yes, Gwen, whatever you like, please talk to me, anything. And she was like, please never take your clothes off.
Really?
And I was like, oh, yeah.
I don't know if this is inappropriate or not, so no. You've never taken your clothes off.
I mean...
But it was good advice, but you're even more.
Not publicly, but I don't know.
In your private life, that's one thing.
I can say never for a man. I can say that.
JoJo!
Body language. Body language. Body language.
Sure. Last but not least, what does this mean? Gay.
Yeah! I knew that because I saw a video of you doing it.
You got one out of four.
You got the good one though.
When it comes to a snack pack, I can't lie. I wanna ride.
Getting wrong. If you start to lean too far forward, you'll ruin your dental record. If you lean too far back, you probably crack the back of your skull.
Hey, we're in control of you. You are not in control. Before you go. Was there something I could have said to make your heart beat better? If only I'd have known you had a storm to wear.
My whole life, I've been very sheltered. If my team had it their way, I would not be here right now.
Fight!
It's been mentally tough on me.
Goodbye.
Suppressing emotions is not going to be good for you.
I want to call my mom and tell her how much pain there's been.
Lift it up like you mean it.
At the end of this, I want to prove to myself that I can. And I want to prove to the world that I can.
You want yours for life. And tell your friend she's next in love.
Tell Jesus that the bitch is back.
I was in 212 on the uptown and you know what's up or don't.
Seeing if I can distract my mom while she's trying to work. Got her attention. Loved it.
Is this the real life? Is this just a fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy. Too late, but the time has come. Send shivers down my spine, body's aching all the time. Goodbye, everybody, I gotta go. Gotta leave you up behind and face the truth. Mama, ooh, I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, where you do the fandango. Thunderbolts and lightning, red, red, lightning. Me, I love you.
Jojo Siwa.
I was never straight. I knew that. And but I also was never like, oh, I'm gay. And I had told myself for a long time, I was like, one day, like, if I have someone to come out with, then I will come out. And so the TikTokers from the Pride House came over to my house and we did this TikTok together. And it was like to the song, Ain't It Fun? Ain't It Fun? Now That You're One of Us. And after I did it, I called my girlfriend and no one knew about us. No one knew about me even being gay yet. Also, not her being gay, but us as a whole, too. And I was like, I think after they posted this TikTok, like, I think it's gonna out me. And she was like, it for sure is. And I was like, great, sick. And we had been dating for like almost a month at that point. And I was like, all right, cool. So then it did, and that video people were, you know, going bananas over. And so I was like, you know what? We're gonna have some fun with this. And so I did the one to Born This Way, because I was like, the thing is it's true. And that night, actually, one of the members of the Pride House, Molly, she texted me, and I've known Molly since I was like 7. She texted me and she was like, hey, like, if you want us to take this down, like, I'm sorry you're getting all this. And she didn't know. And so I texted her and I was like, honestly, Molly, I was like, I was trying to figure out a way to tell you guys. I was like, but it's true. I was like, I actually am in a really happy relationship with a girl. And it's my first ever. And I was like, so I don't really mind. Like, it's making this all super easy and feel super happy and welcomed. And I love it. And she was like, oh my God, we're so proud of you and all this stuff. And I was like, thank you so much. And then I was like, you know what? It's time. Like, the world's gonna know. And I texted my publicist that morning, because she was like, oh, you gonna do anything else? Like, any other TikToks, any other posts? And I was like, no, no, no. I was like, I'm just gonna kind of let it simmer now. And then that night, I had taken the my cousin, best gay cousin ever shirt picture like 3 days before that, and I posted all my close friends' stories, so that way all my close friends knew. And I was on FaceTime with my girlfriend, and I was like, I wanna post this on my real story. And she was like, do it. And I was like, okay. And so, poof. And then I was like, uh-oh, like, I just did that, and I was like, everyone's gonna kill me. I was like, but I don't care, like, it'll be fun. And it was never, like, scary to me to put out to the world that I was happy or I was in love, because, like, I think I said this right away when it happened, I said this on Fallon, I was like, if everything was to go away because of it, because of me being happy, then it's not meant for me, you know? The most important thing is that I'm happy, and that's what my mom always taught me, and my dad always taught me, is we just want you to be happy. That's all we want for you, is to just be happy.